The day Kate showed Meghan how to curtsy, pregnant Duchess shows royal newcomer how it's done as Miss Markle puts on an assured performance at church on Christmas Day with the Queen. All her red carpet experience had not prepared Meghan Markle for anything like this. And understandably, on her debut alongside the royal family at Sandringham yesterday, there were a few nerves. Miss Markle's smile as she waited for the Queen to depart from church, hanging on for dear life to Prince Harry's arm, was more of a rictus grin. Ahead of the curtsy, both the Duke of Cambridge and her fiancé, Prince Harry, gave her words of encouragement, which she listened to with a smile. And her curtsy to the monarch was, to be frank, more of a wobbly bop. Alongside her, the Duchess of Cambridge showed how it should be done. Kate, now a veteran of such occasions, maintained a relaxed smile, and as she executed the perfect curtsy, correctly done, it involves placing the right foot behind the left and bending briefly at the knees while keeping the upper body straight. Meanwhile, Miss Markle went back to clutching her fiancé's arm as if her very existence depended on it. The brief wobble aside, the US actress put on an assured performance as she looks to cement her place in the new Fab Four, two royal couples set to make the monarchy relevant to a new generation. Certainly Harry and his glamorous fiancée made a fetching sight alongside the Cambridges. Harry, 33, and Meghan, 36, are spending Christmas with William and Kate, both 35, at Anmer Hall, their mansion on the Queen's Sandringham estate in Norfolk. Instead of staying up at the big house with Her Majesty, the two couples are enjoying a much more low-key family Christmas, along with Prince George and Princess Charlotte, just joining the rest of the royals for church and lunch on Christmas Day. For Kate, who is pregnant with her third child, it makes it a much more manageable festive season, allowing her a chance to recharge and relax before April's patter of tiny feet. For Miss Markle, who describes herself as a chilled LA girl, it is an opportunity to wet her feet in the ways of the royal family without all of the formality and fuss. But make no mistake, this is also a sign of the future. William, Kate and Harry have long made clear that they will do things their way, which has sometimes brought them into conflict with other members of the family firm, including Prince Charles. The feeling among royal watchers is that the four of them will make a formidable team. William and Kate, by nature and position more formal and reserved, alongside Harry and Meghan, the glamorous new rock stars of royalty, are set to take the Windsor dynasty into the second half of the century. And judging by the body language on show yesterday, they seem to get on famously. William and Kate even held hands in public as they walked to church, alongside Harry and Meghan, who seem unable to keep their hands off each other. Meghan was elegant in a wide collar, camel wrap coat by Canadian luxury brand Centaur as she made her appearance with the royal family on Christmas Day. Her coat tapered in around the waist and flared out at the hem for the St. Mary Magdalene Church Christmas service. Matching her camel coat with a chestnut brown felt hat, Meghan wore a pair of coordinating 630-pound Stuart Weitzman's Highline high-heeled suede boots. Meghan and the Queen met privately with Harry before their engagement was announced, but had not been seen together by others until today. After her curtsy to the Queen, Harry led Meghan to a wheelchair-ridden well-wisher who had waited in the cold to wish the couple a Merry Christmas. The pair then accepted bouquets from fans as they walked back to Sandringham House. Meghan, with her first curtsy behind her and a day of formal festivities ahead, seemed to loosen up as she greeted and accepted gifts from well-wishers. Kate, who is pregnant with her third child and showed off a small baby bump beneath a striking 2,655-pound tartan Miu Miu coat. She completed her look with a 900-pound round handbag in brown leather and caramel suede with a gold-colored handle made by Chloe, while a pair of Maison Burke diamond earrings added a touch of sparkle to Ms. Markle's classy ensemble. They are the same 3,500-pound snowflake design earrings she wore to her Buckingham Palace dinner last week. It is thought her brown hat may be a Jane Taylor piece, a milliner popular with Kate. It is the first time Meghan and Kate have been pictured together since Meghan and Prince Harry revealed their impending nuptials. The Queen arrived at the service later by car wearing an eye-popping orange jacket with a matching intricate floral hat. She completed her look with a 900-pound round handbag in brown leather and caramel suede with a gold-colored handle made by Chloe, while a pair of Maison Burke diamond earrings added a touch of sparkle to Ms. Markle's classy ensemble. They are the same £3,500 snowflake design earrings she wore to her Buckingham Palace dinner last week. It is thought her brown hat may be a Jane Taylor piece, a milliner popular with Kate. As they made the return journey to Sandringham House after the service was over, Ms. Markle and Harry stopped to chat to some of the crowd who turned out to see them attend church. Among them was Judith Wallace, who was sitting in a wheelchair and is staying at the neighboring Park House Hotel on her first Christmas Day visit to Sandringham. She said Harry recognized her teddy bear called Maureen, which is a mascot for Armed Forces charity SOFA, and her hat which bore the Gurkha Regiment emblem. She said Ms. Markle spoke to them too and was very, very lovely. Tess Gilder, manager of Park House, which describes itself as a unique hotel for disabled people, was with Ms. Wallace. She said of Ms. Markle, "She was just so natural, so lovely." She added, "I think they just wished us a happy Christmas and were interested in whether we had been before." Emily Randall, 31, was first in the queue to get into the area by the church with her boyfriend Jamie McKay, 42. She said they set out from Chichester in Sussex before 10 p.m. on Christmas Eve and arrived at Sandringham around 2 a.m. She said, "We thought it would be really busy. We looked online. We were the first ones here camping in the dark for 2 hours." She said they had missed the Queen when she visited Chichester, so decided to make the trip to Sandringham. Back at Sandringham House, the royal family traditionally indulge in turkey, reared at Sandringham, before settling down to watch TV, including the Queen's Christmas speech. This year, it is understood that Prince Harry and his fiancée will stay with Prince William and the Duchess of Cambridge Kate at Aylmer Hall, their home in the Sandringham grounds, rather than in the main house. Markle will have to adjust to the royal family's idiosyncratic ways and customs, ingrained in centuries of tradition. The royals exchange gifts on Christmas Eve, in keeping with German practice. Markle is reportedly an animal lover but will have to put up with royals' tradition of going out shooting on Boxing Day. The Queen arrived in a car and joined the group from the house, which also included the Duke of Edinburgh and the Prince of Wales. Hundreds of well-wishers turned out to catch a glimpse of the royal family, with some calling out Merry Christmas as they walked past. Earlier this morning, Prince Philip led the charge with Prince Charles following closely behind. He walked with his wife Camilla, who wore a scarf to cope with the cold. His other sons Andrew and Edward were accompanied by their sister Princess Anne, who sported a royal purple shawl with a hint of festive red over a deep blue coat. But not all of the family were dressed so spectacularly, with Princess Beatrice opting to shun high heels for a pair of dirty trainers, leaving her father the Duke of York looking distinctly unimpressed. The royal family appeared to be in markedly higher spirits this morning compared to last year when the Queen was forced to miss the service while recovering from a heavy cold. She and the Duke of Edinburgh had delayed their trip to the private Sandringham estate by a day after they both became ill.